I just make this one in like a three part. I'd like to, you know, make this one because it's too long, right? This is 법 21조 제1항 법문을 위반하여 허가를 받지 않고 근무처를 변경하거나 추가한 사람. If an alien staying in the Republic of Korea intends to change or add his her workplace within the scope of his her status of stay, he she shall obtain prior permission from the Minister of Justice, right? If they want to change and move to another workplace, they have to get permitted from the Minister of Justice. If you violate the law and if you move to another place without permit less than 3 months, you will be fined 1 million won. 3 months to less than 6 months, 2 million won. 6 months to less than 1 year, 3 million won. The rest of the things that you can read this one, right? So, if you make a contract and got permitted your status of stay, right? The for example, E7 visa, right? So if you do, you have to work at that place with that hiring company, but without any permission from Minister of Justice, if you work and at the other places, right? You got be fined, right? So the read this very carefully. 출국관리법 제21조 제2항을 위반하여 근무처의 변경 또는 추가 허가를 받지 않은 외국인을 고용 알선한 사람. No person shall employ any aliens who fails to obtain prior permission to change or add his her workplace under the main sentence of this paragraph one, nor arrange the employment of such alien. But, you know, provided that the deed shall not be applied where the employment is arranged the pursuant to the other act. But this like this, right? So somebody introducing and the foreigners, right? Without permitting and the workplace change or additional the permission, the violate and that kinds of person and introduce that kinds of were not permitted and instead of stay and working at a different place. If introduced one person, 1 million, two persons, two, four, 2 million, five to nine, and 3 million. Okay. 법 제21조 제2항을 위반해서 근무처의 변경 허가 또는 추가 허가를 받지 않은 외국인의 고용을 업으로 알선한 사람이 있습니다. There is no person shall employ any alien who fails to obtain prior permission to change or add his or her workplace under the main sentence, right, paragraph one, nor arrange the employment of such alien, right? This one is, if somebody is violate just the paragraph two and introduce that kinds of a not permitted workplace or additional working permit and introduce to someone, right? And the kinds of a and the licensed person, right? The head of the company, right? And that kinds of person, the after, you know, violate their certain law, right? Without the workplace change or additional working permit and introduce one person, right? Is a one a 10 million won and interest one person, two person to four, 50 million won. The five to nine is a 20 million won. This is related to the headhunting company, right? Is actually not related to you. 출입국관리법 제22조에 따른 제한 등을 위반한 사람. The Article 22 of Immigration Law is a restrictions on scope of activities, right? If it is deemed necessary for the maintaining public peace and order or important interest of the Republic of Korea, the Minister of Justice may restrict the residence or scope of the activities of any alien staying in Korea or determine necessary matters to be observed by such alien, right? So if the violet this restriction one time 3 million won, two times 5 million won, three times 10 million won. 법 제23조를 위반해서 체류 자격을 받지 않고 체류한 사람. Article 23 is a granting instead of stay. So, an alien born in the Republic of Korea and staying without being granted instead of stay under Article 10, and an alien staying without being granted instead of stay due to any other ground, such as loss or renunciation of the nationality of the Republic of Korea while staying in the Republic of Korea, shall obtain the status of stay and respectively and within 90 days from the date of his or her birth and within 30 days from the date of the which such ground occurs. The for example, if you work and if you want to stay in Korea, you have to get a certain status of stay, right? So, certain aliens are staying without being granted status of stay, right? And if you violate the law, right? This Article 23 is, and the foreigners and born in Republic of Korea, right? If someone and a child is born in Korea, right? But staying without granted status of stay, that is a violate the law. So it's 90 days means are if the one of the child was born in Korea, right? And your child shall be the granted and certain visa time within 90 days. So what you have to do? So if your child is born and report to your embassy, right, to get your passport, and after that you have to report your child within 90 days, right? And apply for the proper and the visa to status here. So, if you violate the you forgot or and the reporting and the registration of the ARC, and if this period passed after 90 days, right? Passed 1 month and 500,000, 1 month to the 3 month, that 1 million won, 3 months to 6 months, 2 million won, 6 months to 1 year, 5 million won. So, but I just already posted it a certain, and a person's child was born in Korea. So, you have to report and to the immigration office within 90 days, right? This is a very, very important. You need to report that as quickly as possible after getting your child and passport, right? 출입국관리법 24조를 위반해서 체류 자격 변경 허가를 받지 않고 다른 체류 자격에 해당하는 활동을 한 사람. Article 24 is a permission to change status of stay. If you have a D10 visa, right? If you want to work in Korea, you have to change your current D10 visa to E7 visa to work properly, right? So that is the Article 24 is for the permission to change the status of stay. If an alien staying in the Republic of Korea intends to engage in any activity permitted under status of stay not covered by his or her original status of stay, the alien shall obtain prior permission to change his or her original status of stay from the Minister of Justice. And paragraph 2, a person who falls under any subparagraph of Article 31 and 1 and intend to change his or her status of stay due to a change of his or her status shall obtain permission to change his or her original status of stay from the Minister of Justice within 30 days of the change of his or her status. This is a very important part, right? So, if you want to do and you have to get the proper visa, right? So, if you were E7 visa, right? So, you cannot and open your own business. If you want to open your own business, you have to change your current status of stay, such as E7 to F2 visa, right? So, if you change F2, you can and run your own business. So, if you violate the law, and if you do the less than 1 month, 500,000, and the 1 month to 3 months, you will be fined 1,000,000 won. 3 months to 6 months, 2,000,000 won, right? This is a very important thing, so read carefully for the next of the things, right? 법 25조를 위반하여 체류 기간 연장 허가를 받지 않고 체류 기간을 초과하여 계속 체류한 사람. Article 25, permission to extend the period of stay. Every alien who intends to continue to stay in excess of the permitted period of stay shall obtain permission to extend his or her period of stay from the Minister of Justice before the expiration of the permitted period of the stay. So it means if you have a detained visa, right? And before the four months before your visa expiration date, you have to apply for visa extension. If not, if and you have to extend, but it is not, and your period based on your expiration date and the past less than 1 month, you will be fined 500,000. 1 month to less than 3 months, 1,000,000 won. 3 months to less than 6 months, 2,000,000 won. So it is time to extend, but if you cannot extend, it means 1 day after your final visa expiration date, you will be fined 500,000, right? 1 month, 1,000,000. Read very carefully for that, okay? 법, 출국관리법 26조, 제1호를 위반한 사람. 1호를 위반한 사람. Article 26, the prohibition of submission of forged document. No person shall engage in any of the following, act in connection with an application for the permission under Article 20, 21, 23 through to 25, 25-2, 25-3. So, this violation and about detail one is submitting a forged or altered document as evidentiary the materials, submitting an application with a forged statement therein, or otherwise filing an application by other improper means. So if you apply for any kind of visa, right, and you have to submit it and true and the information, and if you submitted certain documentation like your rent contract or your bachelor's degree or criminal record from overseas, so if you forged and changed some of the record on the original document, or changed something and erased something and fake something documentation, or just writing down certain and the forged information on that, and you'll be fined. It is a violation of Article 26 and Item 1, right? So if you one time violate 5,000,000, 5,000,000 won, if you got fined, it means you will be deported, right? The 5,000,000 won, the fine is very, very high, right? So one time you violate the law and the document and the fake document submission or turned certain information and in the and with a with a and change your certain information, right? So all your information and statement and the documents are the forged or changed, right, and submitted one time, right? It'll be fined 5 million won, two times, and 10 million won, right? But if you got one time and got happened, right, 5 million won, the fine, you will be deported, right? Right. Read very carefully. Okay, we can see the next one at the next explanation, okay?